Hi. Global Videos News Post. Welcome to YouTube channel. A surge in violence Saturday left 12 civilians dead in Syria's last major opposition bastion as aid groups warned of a humanitarian catastrophe if cross-border aid stops reaching the region. Heightened regime and Russian bombardment on the northwestern province of Idlib since December 16 has already forced tens of thousands of vulnerable people to flee their homes, according to the United Nations. The world body has called for immediate de-escalation and warned of further mass displacement if the violence continues. The jihadist-dominated Idlib region hosts some 3 million people, including many displaced by years of violence in other parts of Syria. The Damascus regime has repeatedly vowed to take back the area, and bombardment has continued despite a ceasefire announced in August, exacerbating an already dire humanitarian situation. Russia and China on Friday vetoed a UN Security Council resolution that would have extended for a year cross-border aid deliveries to 4 million Syrians, many of them in the Idlib region. The move, slammed by the United States, raised fears that UN-funded assistance could stop entering opposition-held parts of Syria from January unless an alternative agreement is found. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Saturday described the Russian and Chinese veto as shameful. To Russia and China, who have chosen to make a political statement by opposing this resolution, you have blood on your hands, he said. Aid group Oxfam said people in need, many of them displaced several times, relied on the deliveries. There is no realistic way of reaching hundreds of thousands of these families except through cross-border operations, a statement said. Abu Zaker, a 70-year-old living in a camp in northern Idlib, voiced fears for the fate of the displaced if the deliveries were halted. Had it not been for the aid, we would have died from hunger, he said. Age of impunity dash, the fears of an aid crisis came as violence intensified in Idlib. On Saturday, airstrikes by the Syrian regime and its ally Russia killed 12 civilians and wounded 36 others, said the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights, a Britain-based monitor. That came on the third day of clashes between regime loyalists and Idlib militants that have killed nearly 140 on both sides, the observatory said. Battles since Thursday have killed 67 jihadists and 15 allied rebels, it added. 57 regime loyalists were also killed, including at least 7 who died Saturday in a car bombing by the country's former al-Qaeda affiliate, Hayat Tahrir al-Sham, HTS. According to the monitor, the Damascus regime, which controls 70% of Syria, launched a blistering offensive against Idlib in April, killing around 1,000 civilians and displacing more than 400,000. Since August, the area has supposedly been protected by a ceasefire announced by Moscow, but bombardment has continued. Last straw dash. A spike in violence this month highlighted the continued need for life-saving humanitarian aid, which currently flows into Syria through UN-designated checkpoints without formal permission from Damascus. 4 million Syrians directly benefit from the deliveries, among a total of 11 million receiving international aid inside the country 8 years into its devastating war. International Rescue Committee Chief David Miliband warned Friday against scaling back humanitarian access. With a fresh spate of attacks in Idlib, and continued praise and flouting of international humanitarian law, cutting humanitarian aid is the last straw, he said. The development could not come at a worse time of year, as heavy winter rains flood squalid camps for the displaced. UN-supported aid organizations in northwest Syria say they may have to halt operations if cross-border support stops. This will paralyze the humanitarian effort in Syria's north, Mamoun Kabout of the Violet Organization, an aid group, told AFP. Separately, near-simultaneous suspected drone attacks targeted the 3 government-run oil and gas facilities in central Syria at dawn on Saturday, the oil ministry said. There was no immediate claim of responsibility. Global Videos News Post to YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe and follow. Thanks for watching.